Hey guys, welcome back to the Rideshare Hub. I'm Jacob Lettman. There's a lot of questions right now in the rideshare community surrounding the newly expanded unemployment insurance benefits that includes self-employed drivers as well, self-employed personnel as well as, which includes rideshare drivers, gig economy workers, anyone who's 1099'd. New expansion program, part of the $2 trillion stimulus act bill that was passed by the government. And so we're getting a lot of questions surrounding that. I'm going to try and get to as many as I possibly can. I'm going to be creating different videos with information as it goes forward. Basically, here's the deal right now. This was literally passed days ago. It hasn't even been a week as I'm shooting this video. And so basically, the way those funds are going to be dispersed, they're going to go to each state, and each state has their own separate unemployment insurance office. So it's a state-run program. So the first thing is, we need for the states to update their websites and their platforms in order to be able to even accept the applications from rideshare drivers and self-employed people. So we got to wait for that to happen. Once that happens, by the way, the place where you can find that information is to search on Google your state and unemployment insurance. It'll pop up a website. You're going to go there. That's where you're going to file for unemployment insurance benefits. Actually, it's a separate thing. It's called pandemic unemployment insurance, and it's part of the CARES Act that's been passed by the federal government. So those are the things that you're looking for on the website for information. What I want to talk with you guys about right now in this specific video, I want to talk about the application process itself, because I know I read some questions or some comments of other rideshare drivers running into a similar hiccup or having similar questions that I had during my application. So a couple of things. My information that I'm going to give you, I'm not certain it's correct, but after all of the research that I've done and after asking different resources, these are the best answers that I could come up with to help you guys. So again, the first thing you're looking for is you need to wait. Please pump the brakes. Hold up. I know we all want to get these unemployment insurance benefits, but the most important thing to do right now is to wait until your state's unemployment insurance benefits webpage has been updated to accept applications from self-employed personnel. I know I read one comment of someone in Nevada that said they filled out an online application and they already received back information saying that they were deemed ineligible. Now, I don't know for sure, but if you submitted as a self-employed person before they update their website, then most likely that's what would happen, because until they get the information, until they update their state website, it's not essentially into effect yet. Even though it's passed into law, logistically, we have to wait until the state plays catch up and gets all of the pieces in place so that we can apply. So once you've gone to your website, you see that now they have updated it and expanded it to accept applications from self-employed people, including rideshare drivers, then you can go ahead and follow the correct links to begin your application process for unemployment insurance. Okay, so state of Arizona, they actually updated it pretty quick. They updated it on the Tuesday, so it was Friday, last Friday. I don't have my calendar in front of me, so I don't know the dates. March something or other, Friday, passed into law. It was signed by President Trump, officially making it a law. They put some information on the state websites for unemployment insurance on the weekend. And here in Arizona, they updated the website Tuesday afternoon. I was able to apply Tuesday evening. So here's what I found. Couple of things. They're going to ask for basic information, your name, address, social security number, if you have a state ID, that information. I'm assuming that most of the state applications are going to be fairly similar, maybe different. Again, each state is individualistic in this. So they may have a slightly different process. Anyway, I was expecting it to be a long, drawn-out online application. It was not that. I think what the situation is, could be wrong, but I think what the situation is that they've got this new online application now that's set up for self-employed people, because as I went through, it asked, it had a checkbox saying, are you self-employed or are you, do you own a farm? Something like that. I don't own a farm. But anyway, yes, I click self-employed, and it asks if you have been affected due to what's going on in the world with the sickness everywhere. And so let's see, I'm trying to think. Okay, they asked that. And then it asks for, it has a page of who are you employed by. So for that, I put self-employed. I think it put like business. It had the question of business and then maybe type of business below that. So, or employer, type of business, something to that effect. I put my name. I think you could also put self-employed. Either or should be fine. And then for me, I put rideshare driver / actor / golf instructor, because those are all of my self-employed businesses, basically. So I just put all of those in there, filled out that information. How long have you been working there? So how long have you been working for yourself? You technically don't work for Uber or Lyft because you're 1099'd. Anyway, I think it's going to be fine. If you don't fill it out exactly how they're looking for, I think it's going to be fine. I think, and actually, hold up, the website here actually says we don't currently have all of the information or the funds in regards to the CARES Act, but we are now currently accepting applications from self-employed people. So go ahead and apply, and then, and that's kind of all the information it gave. Okay, so where was I at, right? You're filling in the self, the information about being self-employed, how long you've been there. It asked how much you had invested in your business. I wasn't really certain what to put there. I'm not sure if it matters if that's high or low. I don't know if it has any indicator at all, if that holds any bearing whatsoever. But you can. You feel free to put how much you have invested in your business. I would assume your vehicle would fall under that. Again, I don't know if it's that important or not, but the question was there. And what else was asked? Sorry, I'm drawing a bit of a blank here. Type of business, how long you've been employed for. Oh, how many hours a week you work for, doing everything. For me, I put 40, which is true. I work 40 plus hours in my various business practices. Didn't have any questions as to how much you make or anything like that. And then what, okay, so that was all fine and dandy, right? Pretty basic, self-explanatory, you can get through that. Now the next page got a little more confusing, at least I thought. It asked for, said no matter what state it was in, what is the last employer that you worked for? Or who was your last employer? So for me, I have been self-employed for nearly 4 years. So again, my last employer was Golf Tech in California nearly 4 years ago. I was not certain, and I'm still not certain, if they're asking for that previous job nearly 4 years ago, which I can't imagine, or if they're asking for my most recent. It was confusing, and I'm not certain what the answer is. I think it's going to be okay either way, but for me, I put, again, I put employed by myself, I put my personal information as the business information, that's what I did. Now, here's what's going to happen. So I went through that, finished the application, there wasn't much more past that, basically, and in Arizona, you actually have to weekly fill out, every week you have to fill out a new application for unemployment insurance benefits. Anyway, that aside, If you go through this and there are any errors, how it's going to work is they are going to send you in the mail something where they need clarification, they need more information, and you have an opportunity to fill that out in detail and send it back. I don't know if all correspondence needs to be through the mail with them, so I'm telling you this now because it's going to be a process. I know we're all hurting for money. We all need these benefits, but just expect that it's going to take a little while. They're going to be super backed up at all of these offices nationwide. Supply and demand, they're just understaffed. That's just how it's going to be. So be patient. Keep doing your due diligence. Read everything thoroughly. Don't jump the gun. It's a process. That's what I'm trying to tell you. So anyway, I'm expecting to get a letter back. When I do, I'll obviously update you guys and find out if I filled that out correctly or not. If they actually did want my last employer nearly 4 years ago, whatever it may be. Okay. So that was the application process itself that I went through. So again, just to reiterate, once they update your state's website and it says we are now accepting applications for the CARES Act, which includes self-employed personnel, that's your call. Then you can apply. Don't jump the gun and do it before that, but go through the process, fill it out to the best of your ability. Don't worry too much if you're a little confused. It's okay, just fill it out to the best of your ability. Again, it's a process. People are going to do it wrong. That's to be expected. It's going to work out in the end. We'll get to figure it out together. All right. If you guys have any questions on the application process itself, jump down into the comment section below. I will be going through there, reading your questions. I want to get everyone all the information I can on this topic so that if you possibly can be eligible for unemployment insurance benefits and get some additional help, that I'm making sure everybody gets the information that they need in order to do so. So that's what I have for you guys on the application process. Again, I'll update you as I get more correspondence back from the state office and continue the process. All right, look out for my other videos regarding unemployment insurance benefits. I'm going to be covering a whole bunch of topics and questions that you guys are throwing out there. All right, that's what I got for you guys. I'm Jacob Lettman. This is the Rideshare Hub. Until the next time, stay safe out there, everyone.